Democratic Congressman Adam Schiff of California is a key member of the U.S. House Intelligence Committee. Congressman, thanks very much for joining us. I know you've been speaking with your staff on the Intelligence Committee and others. What are you hearing about what happened today and earlier in the week, for that matter, in Canada?
Well, obviously, there's been a chatter for some time. ISIS encouraging people to undertake self-radicalized attacks, low-tech or high-tech. They don't care as long as Western targets are gone after. We don't know yet, as you point out, Wolf, whether this was a terrorist-inspired attack, but if it was, it's certainly consistent with what ISIS has been urging. So I think FBI taking some prudent steps today to raise alert among the FBI offices and make sure either from a copycat attack perspective or because of this chatter, it's a very prudent step.
And so a lot of our viewers hear the word chatter. They're not exactly sure what that means from the intelligence, law enforcement, military perspective. What does that mean?
Well, that means basically that in addition to ISIS in its videos and propaganda urging these kind of things, we either through signals intelligence or maybe human intelligence pick up people within jihadi circles talking about there's an attack coming, or they may use code terms for that, but depending on the veracity of it, depending on how much we're able to verify, depending on the sources of it, depending on the volume of it, it can raise alarm bells here at home.
And so presumably that so-called chatter resulted in Canada increasing its threat level last week.
Yeah, I'm sure that had a big part in this. And obviously, if it turns out that terrorism was the motivation here, coming so close on the heels of an attack 2 days ago in Canada, that will only further raise alarm bells in Canada and here at home.
And the suspicion is because Canada is supporting the United States with these airstrikes against ISIS targets in Syria and Iraq.
Exactly. And this is something that, Wolf, we've been concerned about for some time, and that is the potential of these homegrown attacks using very low-tech means, not hard to get weapons either here or in Canada, and to utilize them to damaging consequence. As we see. So very hard to protect against this. Intelligence is really our best defense against something like this, but even intel obviously isn't perfect.
And we don't know what the cause or what the motivation was for these attacks today and earlier in the week in Canada, but there's a lot of fear, there's a lot of suspicion. It could be what Matt Olson, now the former head of the U.S. Counterterrorism Center, what he told our own Jim Sciutto, our chief national security advisor, yesterday. They were deeply concerned about these lone wolf, self, if you will, mobilized, energized terrorists who may just decide, inspired by the internet, to go ahead and undertake these kinds of operations.
Well, that's exactly right. I mean, if you had to diagram out what are the most proximate threats to the country, you would probably put the lone wolf attacks, low-tech lone wolf attacks, right in the bullseye. Then, you know, more distant, you would say an overseas organized attack on the homeland, and probably the most distant threat is, you know, sort of a massive 9/11 style attack. But while these are not as damaging as that massive kind of 9/11 attack, nonetheless, deeply distressing and can result in loss of life, as we're seeing in Canada.
Because on Monday, we did this vehicle attack killing a Canadian soldier, and then now 2 days later, we see these other attacks going on in the Parliament as well as in the National War Memorial. So the two suspicions I had, and I want you to weigh in if you could, either they're connected, or if they're not connected, they could be potentially copycat, or they could just be separate incidents. We don't know yet, but those are the suspicions, those are the fears.
Absolutely, and we'll find out, I think, in very short order. It may be that the two are completely unrelated, except that the subsequent attack may have been inspired by the earlier attack, or they may have decided to literally pull the trigger on today's attack because of concerns about increased security after the attack a couple days
ago. You haven't heard anything about the U.S. elevating its threat level.
I haven't, and you know, I think there's been a real effort since the color-coded terror alert days to make sure that when we do raise the threat level, that we're giving people specific information about what they need to guard against, rather than just sort of heightening people's anxiety. But I think the steps that the FBI is taking, that NORAD may be taking, these are prudent things.
Out of an abundance of caution.
Absolutely.
As they like to say, Congressman Adam Schiff, thanks very much for